They get confused when I rhyme with eloquence. Since when were all the sheep reduced to spineless skeletons? Eyes glued to the television. They tie the noose with lies the news is telling them. Advertisements bruise intelligence and get you buying useless excrement. Why are you content with it? They wire you to accept this shit. I could use some kind of muse to inspire new thought instead of this. Cause I don't give a fuck about your college and your knowledge and your lessons, kid. Why should I get a job and ingest your bottled sedatives? And why should I acknowledge your causes and your sentiments, your laws and your politics and presidents? All of it's irrelevant. Holler if you conscientiously object to it. God's daughters are not meant to be celibate. I watched them from afar so as not to be rejected, but I also probably won't get a kiss. To hell with the rest of it. The only time I've ever been to heaven is when my lips were interlocked with a she-devil's lips. I'll keep pedaling uphill until I reach my bed of withered roses and rest my head upon a pillow filled with decomposing feathers plucked from an angel's wings. I was never much, I just came to sing and maybe bring a little inspiration into your life. Perhaps a new perspective or a blessing for the mic. And if I capture beauty's essence, I will send it toward this sight so it enters your perception and you catch it with your eyes, your ears, or whatever you perceive with. Don't fight, your tears still eventually recede into the air as they evaporate, and they'll come back as rain so that another human being feels that exact same depression. And then you see that everything's attached and connected, and it may only be a matter of seconds till you're dead, but take solace in the fact that your rotting body will fertilize a flower. My apologies, I forgot the keys to happiness. Plus, I don't know how to pick the lock. I'm romantically hopeless and I've got a bone to pick the flesh off. I walk alone during the death march, begging for a rest yet dreading the next stop. Death stalks us day and night. The best parts of this crazy life are the parts when death is close but overshadowed by the passion. The moments that overpower the absence of emotion and shattered devotion to that which doesn't matter. A black cat is not a bad omen. In fact, it's a gift. Death exists only to remind us to live. So don't reject it or pretend that it's a myth. It doesn't end a cycle. The 85 years to which your essence is confined to is less than a second in the never-ending life flow. Your existence is only a segment in the line, yo. The fist you made to hit your brother with and the lips you used to kiss your lover with will fade into the soil to fertilize the beauty of life.